Well, I came to the University of Arkansas 35 years ago as a PhD student. I've spent my entire career here. The main thing that I've noticed about my career is the tremendous support I've been given by the University of Arkansas to carry out the research mission, teaching mission, service mission that I've been given. So, a point of gratitude for all of that support. I feel like I've gotten a lot of things done, and I shouldn't say I, our team working in horticulture fruit breeding program is what got the work done. The significance of the Blackberry work is it's produced cultivars that are adapted in Arkansas for Arkansas farmers. They're used in other states in the region, and they're used coast to coast and on most of the continents in the world. They're a good crop to have, and we've tried to make them even better. For instance, larger fruit size. That way you can pick a lot of blackberries much quicker. Thornless canes. We've kind of gotten away from the bleeding syndrome that you often had with blackberries. We have blackberries that ripen at different times. We have blackberries that have different flavors. We have a blackberry now that will fruit in the fall, at least in particular locations, which in theory makes blackberries not only a summer crop, but also a fall crop, where the climate is conducive to that type of plant.
Dr. Clark is renowned across the world. And so it's not just within the state of Arkansas, it's not in the southern regions, it's not just in academia, it's in the farm sector, it's in the fruit business, it's with the agribusinesses that he associates with, it's his colleagues worldwide. So yes, he is very, very unique in that. Part of the resources that Dr. Clark has available to him is our fruit research station that's in Clarksville. So he has the space, he has the team, he has the ability to really do all of the breeding program that he has, and it's a benchmark for us to really launch our education programs as well as producing the varieties that we have.
The support of the leadership and Dr. Cochran's role has been immeasurable as far as a component of the success of fruit breeding program and my success at the University of Arkansas. Sustainable production in blackberries is one of the most promising areas of fruit production in Arkansas, much more sustainable than some of the other crops that require much more chemical inputs. I've been doing this a long time, and so family has changed over time. My son has grown, and my wife used to be being gone a lot. So that has allowed a certain amount of adjustment over time to do this. And particularly when it begins in June, I usually go to our fruit research station based at Clarksville, and I spend basically the summer there. And then a fair amount of the time, the rest of the part of the year, I'm traveling to various locations where we have additional research sites. So it is a juggling. The future holds a lot of opportunities. With genetics, you're always making new traits or improving those traits. And so we have new horizons in all of our crops that can improve crops of a better quality, better yields, broader adaptation, just a range of opportunities. So the horizon, in many ways, is brighter today than when I showed up 35 years ago.